living organism have the different characteristic feature. In last previous years, we know very well about the characteristic feature of the living organism. That is, many features they show, that like movement, response, and metabolism, and reproduction. So reproduction is the important feature of living organism. Our first topic in 12th examination is reproduction in lower and higher plants. So reproduction in lower and higher plants. So reproduction, you know very well about the reproduction. Reproduce, synthesize, you are producing a young one, but lower and higher. So lower plants, what is lower plant and what is higher plant? So lower plants, generally, they have non-vascular plants, and higher plants means they have the vascular plant. Now first, that is most important process in living organism or important characteristic feature of living organism is reproduction, which is very important, very essential, and very, very taking part in evolution. So what is reproduction? We will see first the meaning of the reproduction. So reproduction is the ability of a living organism to producing young one from their parental one of their same kind. Teen is important isn't it? Ability is an ability of producing young one from where? From their parent, and how they are look. So they are the similar to their parents. That is the exact definition of the reproduction. Ability of producing young one from their parent of their same kind. Agar donkey hai, to uska young one bhi donkey rahega. Elephant hai, to uska young one bhi elephant rahega. Human hai, to uska young one human rahega. That is the life begets life. In standard 8, you already studied about a life begets life. So like that only, the ability. So reproduction is the ability of producing young one from their parents of their same kind. Same kind, you know very well about the same kind. But reproduction have type. So how many types of reproductions are occurs in the universe? In the universe. So major category of type of reproduction is sexual and asexual. So what is sexual and asexual? It's a big discussion. So sexual means what and asexual means what? So sexual means, or what? Asexual means, here are the, some differences between the sexual and asexual. So first of all, what sexual requires? So sexual requires the biparents. Biparents means kya? Do parents. Sexual ke liye do parents ki zarurat hoti hai. Male and female. Hamesha yaad rakhne wali baat. Male and female. So both the parents are required in sexual reproduction. Whereas in asexual reproduction, it is not required. Only one parents are required for the further generation of the new one or the young one from the parental one. So uniparent, suppose a rose plant, if you cut the rose plant stem and it will grow, it means only taking part of one parent. But here, suppose a man requires two parents for their children. So second characteristic feature, the gamete formation. In 11th standard last year, I already discussed with you that gametes formation. So what is gamete? Gamete is the nothing but the reduction division. It's occur from the meiosis, and when gamete formation is there in any living organism, it fix or confirm that living organism belongs to the sexual reproduction. Whereas in asexual reproduction, there is no formation of gametes. Gametes isme banne wale nahi hai, gamete ki zarurat hi nahi hai, to kaise gametes banenge? Aur yahan par gametes formation hona zaruri hai, kyunki gametes banenge. Gametes kya hai, you know very well in last year, sperm and ovum. So sperm and ovum, these are the gametes for required sexual reproduction. Both union of, you know very well about the union of the sperm and ovum, and then form zygote. So that required only in sexual reproduction, whereas there is no need to gamete formation. Suppose in a garden, if you want to grow a new plant from the parental one, if you cut the stem by cutting maker, so there is no requirement of the gamete, there is no requirement of the both the parents couple. So here gamete formation is very important. Here in asexual reproduction, no gamete formation. Third difference between the sexual and asexual is fertilization. You know very well about the fertilization in previous years, 9, 10, 11. That is, fertilization means union of this male and female gamete. When sperm unite with the ovum, it forms the zygote. That is nothing but the fertilization. There is no by parents in asexual, there is that, that's why here no fertilization occur in asexual reproduction. So fertilization is the symbol, is the sign of sexual reproduction, whereas in asexual reproduction no fertilization, there is no need of fertilization in asexual reproduction. So next one, complex. This entire sexual process is very complex. Complex means it's very chain of reaction. So complex or the big reaction, sexual reproduction is a complex reaction, whereas in asexual reproduction it's simple. Simple process. Simple process means if you cut the leaf, you cut the stem, you cut the root, if you grow into the soil, it gives you a new one or the new plant. That is the simple, and within a short of time. But here sexual, there is a sperm and union formation, then after zygote formation, then fertilization occurs, then post fertilization changes, and then seed will form, and then that seed are responsible for the new plant. So it's very 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 complex process, sexual reproduction. Whereas in asexual reproduction, there is no union, no zygote, no fertilization. It grew directly from the simple parental one. Now next, which is very important process, it's connect with our human being, that slow process. If it require time, we never multiplicate any plant. So it's a very slow process. See, human being, 9 months, after fertilization, 9 months are required to take out a baby or to a new baby. So slow process, but here it gives a fast. If you cut the stem from any plant, or if you grow any another plant from the asexual process, it grow fast within a one day, 2 day, 3 day or 4 day. It requires a larger time. Variation, it's very very important. Variation means what? Variation means tagayur, changes, new. Suppose sexual reproduction is just like I want to give you an example. Suppose I have the red color and I have the yellow color. If I mix red and yellow, I will form. Suppose this is my, I am having the red color, and here also I am having the red color and yellow color. Suppose I mix these two color, it will give me orange. Which color? Orange. Very good. So orange color I got after mixing the red and yellow. So it give variation. I have red color, I have yellow color, but I does not have orange color, but I got orange color after mixing these two colors. So here variation occurs. When variation occurs? When two different things are mixed together. But here in asexual reproduction, no variation in asexual reproduction, because of there is no matching, or there is a single parent, there is not two characters are mixing here. Suppose here example, sperm and ovum. Sperm have its own characteristic, ovum have its own characteristic, and when zygote form, after mixing these two, zygote will form, and this zygote is combination of male and female gamete. So it have the two characteristics or two features. That's why variation will occur in the next generation. But in asexual reproduction, there is no variation, and it also called as clone. Clone means what? Both the parents and offspring, when identical to each other, that is to be called as clone. So clone means what? When parents, just young ones are similar to their parents, is called as clone. But clone occurs only in asexual reproduction. So it's a big difference between the sexual and asexual reproduction. Variation play a vital role in a evolution. So next, higher plant. So sexual reproduction occurs majorly in a higher plants, and I know already explained what is higher plant. Higher plants are vascular plant, big plants which can be easily visible to our naked eyes, that belongs to the higher plant. And in asexual reproduction, it occurs in lower plant. And where, what is lower plant? Algae, fungi, bryophyta, pterophyta, all small, teeny and primitive. It's not exact definition of the higher and lower plant, but generally listen one thing, higher means vascular and lower means non-vascular, and lower means the primitive one, oldest one, and higher means the advanced and latest feature of that plant. So these are the differences of the sexual and asexual reproduction, and this is the first topic, reproduction in lower and higher plant. So students, what we learned today, the definition of reproduction, which is oldest one. In last year also you have seen the reproduction definition, ability of producing young one from parental one of the same kind. उसके ही जैसा, parents के ही जैसा खुद अपना छोटा parts, आप छोटा your individual अगर produce करेंगे तो reproduction बोलेंगे. Type कितने mate, type तो बहुत है, type बहुत है, sexual, vegetative, different types are there in sexual, but major they are categorized into two categories, sexual and asexual reproduction. Now what is sexual and what is asexual? Sexual means there is a union of two parents. Here asexual there is no need or no union required for the reproduction. Gamete formation, gamete will be formed, you know very well about the gamete formation, after meiosis gametes are formed. Gametes are the reduction division of the genetic material. So gamete forms are needed in sexual reproduction, whereas in asexual no gamete formation is there. Fertilization when occurs, when the union of the male and female gametes are occurs, then fertilization occurs. There is no need in asexual reproduction. There is no need of the fertilization in asexual reproduction. It's very complex process. It is not a complex process. Next, it's a slow process. Slow means step by step, each reaction are coming, after that one by one reactions are coming. That's why it's a slow. And here it's fast, comparatively fast. It grow faster. Variation, again I am repeating, variation is very important. Hybridization, we will see the next, the hybridization process, that is very connected to the variation. So variation occurs only in sexual reproduction, where is no variation in asexual reproduction. Means asexual reproduction is continuously growing on, there is no variation, just primitive plant, just copy of the primitive plant. And they occur, where they occur? They occur in a higher plant and they occur in a lower plant. Majorly it's reproduction, sexual reproductions found in higher plants, whereas lower plants shows asexual reproduction. In my next lecture, we will see asexual reproduction in detail. In my next lecture, we will see the asexual reproduction in detail. Okay.